Hello all, welcome to Let's Crack NEET PG. Myself Dr. Apurva Mittal and I am your educator for anesthesia on this prestigious platform of Unacademy, and today I'll be discussing about anatomy of spinal cord in regional anesthesia. Like I'll be talking about regional anesthesia from now on, and first lecture is anatomy of spinal cord. Before starting our today's topic, let me tell you how can you get the Unacademy advantage. So you can install the Unacademy learning app, and by installing the Unacademy learning app, okay, after that you can subscribe for Plus or the Iconic subscription. Now, advantages of the Plus subscription: you have a classroom like environment, like live classes, live tests and quizzes, batch courses and structured schedule. And if you opt for the Iconic subscription along with the Plus subscription advantage, we have Prep Ladder, in which you will have the video lectures, question bank, rapid revision course and the handwritten notes. And these subscription, the Iconic subscription, you can take for 1 year, 2 year or 3 year. And if you apply my code, that is Apurva Live, you can get 10% discount on the same. Similarly, if the Plus subscription, okay, the Plus subscription you can get for 1 month, 3 months, 6 months. And here also, if you apply my code, that is Apurva Live, you will get 10% discount on the same. So let's start our today's topic, that is anatomy of the spinal cord. Before that, let me introduce to the regional anesthesia. Now, what is regional anesthesia? See, regional anesthesia is we are blocking a region. Okay, so in this, the drug, that is what drug? The local anesthetic, it is deposit around the nerve we want to block. Like, if I want to perform the shoulder surgery, I can just block the brachial plexus, okay, the upper cord and the middle cord of the brachial plexus, and then I can, easily operate on the shoulder. So that is what is the regional anesthesia. And in this, there is basically reversible. Remember, it is the reversible loss of the autonomic sensory and the motor sensation, which is carried by that nerve, and the area supplied by it is anesthetized. So that is regional anesthesia. Now, how can we give regional anesthesia? We are just blocking a particular area. So that can be done by topical anesthesia, like lignocaine jelly when we apply, okay, infiltrate that area, and that area nerves will be anesthetized. The conduction block, the field block and the nerve block, very important, the intravenous regional anesthesia, the Byers block. What it is, how it is done, I'll take it in the separate lecture. And the central neuraxial anesthesia, which I'll be discussing in detail in my subsequent lectures. So this is about the regional anesthesia. Remember, this regional anesthesia is very important topic from anesthesia, because around 30 to 40% of the questions are asked in all the exams. So it is a small, simple topic, but many questions are asked from this, and therefore this is very important. Clinically also it is very important, but theoretically for your exams it is a very important topic. So the central neuraxial block, what is central neuraxial block? In this, the local anesthetic, the drug, is placed around the nerves of the central nervous system. For example, the spinal anesthesia, I am depositing the drug around the spinal nerves. I am depositing the drug around the spinal nerves in what? In subarachnoid space. In subarachnoid space. So therefore, it is an example of spinal anesthesia. If I am depositing the drug to block the spinal nerve in the epidural space, then that is the epidural anesthesia. So this is the central neuraxial block. Basically, I am blocking what? I am blocking the spinal nerves. I am blocking the spinal nerves. Okay. Now, coming to the anatomy, the vertebral column, as you all know, ठीक है, ये जो वर्टिब्रल कॉलम है ये किससे बनता है? ओके, द स्पाइन. ओके, द स्पाइन, इट इज कंपोज्ड ऑफ व्हाट? इट इज कंपोज्ड ऑफ द वर्टिब्रल बोन्स. इट इज कंपोज्ड ऑफ द वर्टिब्रल बोन्स, और इन वर्टिब्रल बोन्स के बीच में देयर आर द इंटरवर्टिब्रल डिस्क. So how many vertebral bones we have? We have 7 cervical, 12 thoracic, 5 lumbar, and sacrum. Sacrum, adults, it's one. Okay, it is what? It is the fusion of 5 sacral vertebra. And lastly, we have coccyx. Okay, but there are 31 pairs. Remember, there are 31 pairs of the spinal nerves. Why? Because from the first cervical vertebra, ठीक है, इसमें ऊपर और नीचे से दोनों से spinal nerves emerge होती है, ठीक है, और सब vertebra से it is from the lower side. So because from the C1, okay, C1 vertebra from up and down, so therefore there are 31 pairs of the spinal nerves. Now coming to spinal canal and the spinal cord. ठीक है, क्यों? स्पाइनल कॉर्ड से ही स्पाइनल नर्व्स निकल रही है, राइट? सो स्पाइनल कैनाल, एज द नेम सजेस्ट, कैनाल, इट्स अ कैनाल, ठीक है, हॉलो ओपनिंग. सो इट इज व्हाट? इट इज अ हॉलो स्पेस. जैसे ये जो वर्टिब्रल बॉडीज हैं, ठीक है, ये जो वर्टिब्रा है, व्हेन दे आर स्टैक टुगेदर टू ईच अदर, तो उसके बीच में जो फोरामेन है, ओके, दैट फॉर्म्स अ हॉलो पैसेज. And that is called as the spinal canal. So spinal canal, it is a hollow passage which is formed by the foramen of the vertebra. And through this spinal canal, okay, through this spinal canal is the spinal cord which runs, okay. Through this spinal canal, the spinal cord runs. And remember, ye jo spinal canal hai, okay. It extends from the base of the skull till the sacrum. Remember, I'm talking about the spinal canal. I'm not talking about the spinal cord. I'm telling the spinal canal. It extends from the base of the skull till the sacrum. Now, the spinal cord. Okay. Now, as I told you, spinal canal hai. It is a hollow passage. Usi ke andar spinal cord hota hai. What are the other structures which are present in the spinal canal? Okay, so the contents of the spinal canal. Okay, first is the spinal cord, and along with it, spinal cord se kya emerge ho rahi hai? The spinal nerves. So along with it is the spinal nerves. Okay, the roots of the spinal nerves. Then third, okay. स्पाइनल कॉर्ड को एनकवर करते हैं थ्री मेनिंजियल लेयर्स, ओके, थ्री मेनिंजियल लेयर्स, ओके, एंड फ्रॉम इनसाइड टू आउटसाइड इट इज व्हाट? इट इज पाया मैटर, अरेक्नॉइड मैटर एंड ड्यूरा मैटर, फ्रॉम इनसाइड टू आउटसाइड. Right, so this is the spinal cord. ये जो black color का है, this is the spinal cord. इसको ये green color की जो layers हैं, these are the meningeal layers. From inside it is the pia mater, then arachnoid and the dura mater. Okay, and from here emerges the spinal nerves. Okay, so this is there. Then we have fatty tissue. Also the venous plexus, okay, fatty tissue or venous plexus, or is plexus ko hum log bolte hain Batson's plexus. Now friends, remember ye jo spinal cord hai, okay, the spinal cord, iska extension is very important because that will tell us where to give the spinal anesthesia, the level of the spinal anesthesia. Why is it particular? Because the extension of the spinal cord in the adults, okay, in the adults it extends till, okay, in the adults it extends till the lower border, okay, of L1 vertebrae, okay, and in children, okay, it extends till the upper border, okay, upper border of L3 vertebrae. So adults may it is extending till the lower border of the L1 vertebrae, but in the children it is extending till upper border of L3 vertebrae. This is very important, the extension of the spinal cord, and therefore adults mein hum log kya bolte hain, it should be given at L3 L4 level. The spinal anesthesia should be given at L3 L4 level. Why? Because the spinal cord is ending at L1 vertebra. Okay, so if I am giving this anesthesia at L3 L4 level, there are least chances that we will injure the spinal cord. Okay, so to prevent the injury to the spinal cord, we are giving the anesthesia at L3 L4 level, the spinal anesthesia. Okay, now abhi cauda equina kya hota hai? Okay, what is cauda equina is, what happens, ye jo spinal cord hai, ye kahan tak extend ho raha hai? In the adults, it is extending till L1. So the lower lumbar and the sacral spinal nerves, what they do, they traverse a little distance. Okay, ye jo spinal nerves hai, they come out of the corresponding intervertebral foramina. But as the spinal cord is ending at L1 level, the lower lumbar and the sacral nerves, they traverse a little distance before coming out of the intervertebral foramina, and they form the horsetail like appearance, and that is known as cauda equina. Is it clear? No. Sabse important question, spinal anesthesia hai kya? Okay, it is an example of the central neuraxial block. Batae, theek hai, kya hum log block kar rahe, we are blocking the spinal nerves. Theek hai, kis area mein hum log drug ko deposit kar rahe. So remember the spinal anesthesia. Okay, the spinal anesthesia, it is also known as subarachnoid block. Why? Subarachnoid block. Why? Because in this we are depositing the drug. Okay, the drug, the local anesthetic is given between the pia mater and arachnoid space. ठीक है, arachnoid space. तो उन दोनों के बीच में जो ये space है, that is the subarachnoid space, there I am giving my drug. Now, another important thing which is present in this space, can anyone tell me? That is the CSF. So basically, the CSF is present in between the pia mater and the arachnoid, that is in the subarachnoid space, and the spinal nerves are floating in the CSF, and I am depositing my drug there. Okay, so it is in the, so isliye jab bhi hum spinal anesthesia dete hain, hum log dekhte hain backflow of CSF hai ki nahi, because in the subarachnoid space the CSF is present, and if the backflow of CSF is there, then only we give the drug. Okay, is it clear? Okay, now what is epidural space? Okay, what is epidural anesthesia? Okay, what is epidural anesthesia? Epidural. Okay, here it is a space. Okay, outside the dura. Okay, so if I am depositing my drug in a blank space, okay, it has a negative pressure. Okay, it does not have any content. So if I am depositing the drug there in the epidural space outside the dura, that is known as epidural anesthesia, and from that space the drug is getting absorbed and it is anesthetizing the spinal nerves. Okay, now as I told you, what we are blocking, we are blocking the spinal nerves. Okay, in that also what happens, see, this is the cross section of the spinal cord. This is the cross section. This is the gray matter and the white matter. From there we have what? We have the dorsal and the ventral column. Okay, we have the dorsal and the ventral column. Okay, this is the dorsal root ganglia and the ventral root ganglia. Okay, wahan se kya ho rahe hai? The dorsal and the ventral roots are emerging. Okay, before they combine together to form the spinal nerves. Okay, before they combine together to form the spinal nerve. So we are blocking this dorsal root and the ventral root. Okay, so we are blocking, okay, we are blocking the root of the spinal nerve, the roots of the spinal nerves. Okay, and as the dorsal, okay, the dorsal, the posterior nerve root, what does it carry? Okay, the dorsal or the posterior nerve root, it carries the sensory information, and therefore what happens, the sensory sensation is lost. There is reversible loss of the sensory and the autonomic sensation. Okay, because क्या कर रहे डॉर्सल नर्व रूट द पोस्टीरियर नर्व रूट उसको ब्लॉक कर रहे हैं. ठीक है, तो पी एस पोस्टीरियर पी एस हम लोग बोलते हैं ना पी ए. सो द पोस्टीरियर वी आर ब्लॉकिंग द सेंसरी एंड द ऑटोनॉमिक सेंसेशन. बाय ब्लॉकिंग द वेंट्रल नर्व रूट वी आर ब्लॉकिंग द मोटर सेंसेशन. वी आर ब्लॉकिंग द मोटर सेंसेशन. सो द क्रॉस सेक्शन ऑफ द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड फ्रॉम हियर द टू रूट्स द डॉर्सल एंड द वेंट्रल नर्व रूट्स दे इमर्ज. ओके, एंड दे कंबाइन टुगेदर टू फॉर्म द स्पाइनल नर्व व्हिच इमर्जेस आउट ऑफ द इंटरवर्टिब्रल फोरामिना. सो बाय गिविंग द ड्रग वी आर ब्लॉकिंग दीज टू रूट्स. And because these roots carry the sensory, motor and autonomic sensation, therefore we are reversibly blocking the sensation. Okay, now another important question which is asked, what are the layers, okay, the layers which are pierced, okay, by giving the spinal anesthesia. So what are the different structures that are affected by the spinal and the epidural anesthesia? So from outside to inside. ठीक है, बाहर से तो पेशेंट बैठा है. ओके, सो फर्स्ट वी आर पियर्सिंग व्हाट, वी आर पियर्सिंग द स्किन. ठीक है, सो फर्स्ट वी आर पियर्सिंग द स्किन. ओके, देन वी, ओके, सो फर्स्ट इज द स्किन, फिर क्या होगा, द सबक्यूटेनियस टिश्यू. ओके, सो स्किन, ओके, द स्किन, द सबक्यूटेनियस टिश्यू, फिर क्या होगा, फिर हमें वर्टिब्रा मिलेंगे. तो वर्टिब्रा को ऊपर, ओके, देयर आर द स्पाइनस प्रोसेसेस. ओके, द स्पाइनस प्रोसेसेस ऑफ द वर्टिब्रा व्हिच आर कमिंग आउट. तो स्पाइनस प्रोसेस के ऊपर देयर इज अ सुप्रा स्पाइनस लिगामेंट. ओके, सो दीज आर द स्पाइनस प्रोसेसेस. Okay, these are the spinous processes. This is the skin, the subcutaneous tissue, the spinous process. Above that, there is a ligament, and that is known as the supraspinous. In between the spinous ligament, kya hoga? Interspinous ligament. Then, very important, the ligamentum flavum. Now, what is ligamentum flavum? What is ligamentum flavum? It is a fibrous layer. Okay, it is a fibrous layer. Okay, and when we pierce this ligamentum flavum, okay, there is a gritty feeling. Okay, there is a gritty feeling. And when we pierce this ligamentum flavum, it is sure that we have entered into the epidural space. And if I am depositing my drug in this space, that is known as epidural anesthesia. So, jaise hi hum log ligamentum flavum, the gritty feeling, the fibrous layer ko jaise hum pierce karenge, so there will be loss of resistance. Theek hai, the resistance which was offered, there will be loss of resistance. There will be loss of resistance. That means we have entered into the epidural space. And that is where we are depositing the drug, that is epidural anesthesia. Then, epidural space ke baad kya aayega? Dura matter, then, okay, the subdural arachnoid matter, aur uske baad kya aayega? The subarachnoid space where what is present, okay, the CSF is present, and here only our spinal nerves are there. And if I am giving my drug in this space, that is known as spinal anesthesia. Is it clear? So spinal anesthesia mein skin, subcutaneous tissue, supraspinous, interspinous ligamentum flavum. Aur agar epidural anesthesia ke pucha to yahan pe ruk jana hai, that is epidural space. Spinal anesthesia ka dura, subdural, arachnoid, and then I enter into the subarachnoid space. Is it clear? Okay, So as told you, spinal anesthesia is given at L3, L4 intervertebral space. Why? Because in adults, the spinal cord, it extends till the level of the L1 vertebrae. And if I'm giving the drug at L3, L4 level, there are least chances that I can injure the spinal cord. And therefore, it is given at that level. Okay. Now, the dural sac. Okay, the dural sac, the subarachnoid space. Okay. The dural sac, it extends till S2 in adults. This is wrong. Dural sac, it extends till S2 in adults and S3 in children. Okay? The dura sac, agar pucha jaye, to it is S2 in adults and S3 in children. And what is phylum terminale? Corda equina yaad hai? Final terminale is nothing but it is an extension of the pia mater. And it penetrates the dura and attaches the terminal end of the spinal cord to the periosteum of the coccyx. Okay, to the periosteum of the coccyx. Okay, so that is what is the phylum terminale. So, corda equina. Okay, these are the spinal nerves. Okay, the lower lumbar and the sacral spinal nerves, which gives a horse tail like appearance. Okay, now what is phylum terminale? Nothing. It is phylum terminale is nothing but an extension of a pia mater, which extends the spinal cord till the periosteum of the coccyx. And what is conus medullaris? It is the lower end of the spinal cord. Okay, the terminal end. Okay, the conus medullaris. It is nothing but a lower end of the spinal cord. I have written this in at the same place so that there is no confusion. Okay, spinal cord. Okay, fine. Now, the last topic, the blood supply of the spinal cord and the spinal nerve roots. Remember, the blood supply is very important because the spinal cord, it is supplied by a single anterior spinal artery. Okay, anterior. Okay, the anterior spinal artery, the anterior, it is okay, it is single anterior spinal artery but paired posterior PCP. The posterior spinal arteries, they are paired in nature. Okay, so two posterior spinal artery or eight anterior spinal artery. Now, the anterior spinal artery, it is formed from what? This is the vertebra. Okay, the vertebral artery, the anterior spinal artery is formed from the vertebral artery, and the posterior spinal artery, it arises from pica, that is posterior inferior cerebellar artery. But remember, it is only, okay, the anterior spinal artery which supplies the anterior two-third. Okay, it supplies the anterior two-third of spinal cord and it supplies the posterior one-third of spinal cord. Okay, so the anterior spinal artery, it is only one in number. So if there is any damage or if there is any aneurysm or a clot in this anterior spinal artery, so as it is single, okay, so the anterior two-third of the spinal cord won't get the blood supply. But posterior spinal artery, they are paired. So there are less chances of injury in this. So the anterior spinal artery territory, it supplies the anterior portion of the spinal cord. Okay, the anterior portion of the spinal cord is supplied by the anterior and the posterior, the dorsal column. Okay, the posterior spinal artery is supplied by it. Okay, now there is one more artery which is known as artery of Adamkiewicz. Okay, it is also known as arteria radicularis anterior magna. Remember, okay, arteria radicularis anterior magna, bas isko yaad rakhna, it arises from the aorta. Okay, it is unilateral and arises from the left side. And remember, Adamkiewicz arteria radicularis kahan se arise hoti hai? Aorta se. क्या करते हैं मेजर ब्लड सप्लाई टू द एंटीरियर टू थर्ड्स ऑफ द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड. तो अगर इसमें भी कुछ आयोटा में एन्यूरिज्म है, कुछ ट्यूमर है विच इज कंप्रेसिंग दिस पार्ट, सो दिस आर्टरी ऑफ एडामकेविक्स विल बी कॉम्प्रोमाइज्ड एंड देयर विल no blood supply in the anterior two-third of the spinal cord, and therefore there are many cases seen of the anterior spinal artery syndrome. Why? Because it is single and it supplies the anterior two-third where we have the corticospinal and the spinothalamic tract. So if there is any injury, so there will be loss of function which is supplied by the corticospinal, which is the complete motor paralysis, because the corticospinal tract, it carries the motor. Okay, so complete motor paralysis below the level, and spinothalamic, okay, it carries the pain and temperature sensation. So because this tract is there, so there will be loss of sensation below the level, that is the pain and the temperature. Okay, so ye pura, okay, bilateral there will be loss of motor sensation and temperature and pain, but remember the sensation, okay, the vibration and proprioception, okay, which is carried by the dorsal root column, will be preserved in case of the anterior cord syndrome. It will be preserved in the anterior cord syndrome. Is it clear? Okay, now so there are three syndromes which we see mainly. ठीक है, तो ये एंटीरियर में क्या है, स्पाइनोथैलेमिक एंड द कॉर्टिकोस्पाइनल और डॉर्सल कॉलम्स. ओके, सो एंटीरियर कॉर्ड में आई टोल्ड यू देयर इज, बिकॉज द एंटीरियर टू थर्ड वेयर द स्पाइनोथैलेमिक एंड द कॉर्टिकोस्पाइनल ट्रैक्ट्स आर प्रेजेंट, देयर इज बायलेटरल लॉस ऑफ मोटर, रिमेंबर बायलेटरल. ओके, पेन एंड टेम्परेचर सेंसेशन बिलो द लेवल ऑफ दिस इंजरी, बट द वाइब्रेशन एंड प्रोप्रियोसेप्शन आर इंटैक्ट. ओके, आर इंटैक्ट. सेंट्रल कॉर्ड में क्या होगा, बिकॉज इट इज हैविंग द डॉर्सल ऑल्सो एंड दिस एंटीरियर पार्ट, सो सेंसरी एंड मोटर डेफिसिट्स, बट रिमेंबर मोस्टली द अपर एक्सट्रीमिटीज आर इफेक्टेड मोर इन केस एज कंपेयर टू द लोअर एक्सट्रीमिटीज इन द सेंट्रल कॉर्ड सिंड्रोम, एंड इट इज सीन मोस्टली इन द ओल्डर पेशेंट्स. In the older patients, because of the compression of the nerves. Okay, now brown sequid, remember, because of the penetrating trauma. So penetrate kahan se hoga, ek hi side se hoga, so it is unilateral, the ipsilateral loss of the motor vibration and proprioception. Okay, and there is contralateral loss of the pain and temperature. Remember, because the spinothalamic tract, they cross over, so there is contralateral loss of the pain and temperature, but ipsilateral loss of motor vibration and proprioception. So this is how you can differentiate between the spinal cord syndromes. Is it clear? Okay, so that was all for today's class. That was the anatomy of the spinal cord. Very important, the contents of the spinal canal. Where are we giving the drug? In the spinal anesthesia and the epidural anesthesia. Okay, remember, in the subarachnoid space, the CSF is present. Then the extension of the spinal cord, that is very important in the adults and in the children. Okay, it is different, remember. And then the supply, the arterial supply is very important. Remember the artery of Adamkiewicz and the features of the anterior cord syndrome. So that was all for today's class. And on the YouTube, we have a channel, Let's Crack Neat PG. Subscribe to it and click the bell icon and get the notifications of when the class will be held. And click the like button if you like my video. Also, for the Iconic and the Plus subscription, use my referral code Apurva Life to get 10% discount on the same. And on the Telegram app, we have a channel, Let's Crack Neat PG. Through this channel, you can follow us and come to know when the classes will be held. So that was all for today's class. Thank you and have a nice day.